Saint Mina, who is called the Blessed Faithful, was martyred. His father Eudoxius was a native of the city of Nicaeus and was its governor. His brother was envious of him, and he brought charges against him before the emperor. The emperor transferred him to Africa and appointed him governor over it. The people were pleased with him because he was merciful and God-fearing. His mother Euphemia had no children. One day she went to church on the feast of Our Lady, the Virgin, the Mother of God, at Atribis. She saw the children in the church wearing their beautiful clothes with their parents. She heaved a sigh and wept before the icon of Our Lady Saint Mary, entreating her to intercede for her before her beloved son, in order that he would give her a son. A voice came from the icon saying, "Amen." She rejoiced in what she had heard and realized that the Lord had heard her prayers. When she returned to her home and told her husband about it, he replied, "May God's will be done." The Lord gave them this saint, and they called him Mina, according to the voice that his mother heard. When he grew, his parents taught him reading and writing, and they reared him in a Christian manner. When he was 11 years old, his father departed at a good old age. Then his mother departed 3 years later. Saint Mina devoted his life to fasting, praying, and to living a Christian life. Because of everyone's love towards him and his father, they placed him in his father's position. In spite of that, he did not forsake his worshiping. When Diocletian had reneged Christianity and issued his orders to worship idols, many were martyred for the name of the Lord Christ. Saint Mina left his position and went to the desert, where he stayed many days worshiping God with all his heart. One day he saw the heavens open and the martyrs crowned with beautiful crowns. He heard a voice saying, "He who toils for the name of the Lord Christ shall receive these crowns." He returned to the city over which he was governor and confessed the name of the Lord Christ. Knowing that he belonged to a noble family, they tried to dissuade him from his faith and promised him honors and precious gifts. When he did not change his mind, they threatened him, and the governor ordered him to be tortured. When the governor failed to turn him away from his faith in the Lord Christ, he sent him to his brother so that he might influence him, but he failed also. Finally, he ordered his head to be cut off with the sword, his body to be cast in the fire, and his ashes to be scattered in the wind. The body remained in the fire for 3 days and three nights, but it was not harmed. His sister came and gave the soldiers a lot of money, and they let her take the body. She put it in a sack made of fronds and decided to go to Alexandria, as her brother had previously advised her. She embarked with her brother's body on one of the ships to Alexandria. During their trip, sea beasts came out of the water and attacked the passengers aboard the ship. They were frightened and screamed with fear. The saint's sister prayed to the Lord and asked for the intercession of her brother. While the passengers were in fear, fire went forth from her brother's body and burned the faces of the beasts. They dived immediately into the water, and as they reappeared, the fire burned them again. They finally dived and did not reappear. When the ship arrived at the city of Alexandria, most of the people went out with the father, the patriarch. They carried the holy body with reverence and honor and entered the city with a venerable celebration and placed it in the church after they shrouded it in expensive shrouds. When the time of persecution ended, the angel of the Lord appeared to the honorable patriarch and Athanasius the apostolic. The angel informed him of the Lord's command, which was to place the body of Saint Mina on a camel and to take it out of the city without letting anyone lead it, but to follow it from a distance until it stopped at a place that the Lord had designated. They walked behind the camel until they arrived at a place called Lake Bayed in the district of Mariut. There they heard a voice saying, "This is the place where the Lord wishes the body of his beloved Mina to be placed." They lowered the body and placed it in a coffin. Then they situated it in a beautiful garden, and many miracles happened through the body. Later on, the people of Pentapolis rose against the cities around Alexandria. The people were getting ready to face the Berbers, and the governor decided to take the body of St. Mina with him to be his deliverer and his strong protector. He took the body secretly, and through the blessings of the saint, he overcame the Berbers and returned victorious. The governor decided not to return the body of the saint to its original place and wanted to take it to Alexandria. On the way back, they passed by Lake Bayed, St. Mina's original place. The camel carrying the body knelt down and would not move in spite of frequent beatings. They moved the body over another camel, but again, this second camel did not move from its place. The governor finally realized that this was the Lord's command. He made a coffin from decay-resistant wood and placed the silver coffin in it. He then returned it to its place and invoked St. Mina's blessings, then returned to his city. When the Lord wanted to disclose the location of St. Mina's holy body, he did it in this manner. There was a shepherd in the desert. One day, a sheep with mange slipped down into the water of a well near the place of the saint's body. The sheep then came out of the water and rolled over in the sand of that place, and instantly the sheep was healed. When the shepherd saw this miracle, he was amazed. He took some of the sand and mixed it with water and smeared it over every sheep with mange, as well as on those with other infirmities, and immediately they were healed. The news of these miracles spread in all the countries until the emperor of Constantinople heard of them. He had an only daughter, and she was leprous. Her father sent her to the place where the saint's body was, and she inquired from the shepherd how those miracles were happening. She took some of the sand, moistened it with water, smeared it on her body, and slept the night in that place. In her sleep, she saw St. Mina saying to her, "Arise early and dig in this place, and you will find my body." When she woke up, she found herself cured. She began digging, as she was told, and she found the holy body. She sent word to her father, informing him of the news. The emperor rejoiced exceedingly, thanked the Lord, and glorified his name. He then sent men and money and built a church in that place, and it was consecrated on the 15th day of the month of Bona. When Arcadius and Honorius reigned, they ordered a city to be built there. Multitudes of people came to that church asking for the intercession of the blessed St. Mina. The Lord had honored him with many signs and wonders that appeared from his pure body. When the Arabs came to Egypt, some of them attacked the city and the church was destroyed. Only ruins remained. When His Grace, the late Pope Avacadullus VI, was ordained patriarch over the See of St. Mark, he took interest in building a large monastery in the area of Mariut in the name of St. Mina. He spent a great deal of money in establishing it. There are now many churches in the monastery, visited by many Orthodox worshipers who go there to receive blessings and to pray. He also bought 100 acres of land and built a fence around it. He ordained a number of monks who had a high degree of scientific and religious education. May His blessings be with us all, and glory be to our God forever. Amen.